St. Mary and St. Mina's Church was established in 1970 in Sydenham. But before that time, they started in a hall, Salvation Army Hall in Redfern, but relocated to Sydenham after they bought a building there. And that's how they started the church, and had many facilities at that time. One of them is close to the airport, and number two, it's close to the train station as well.
Yeah, at the beginning, it's just started with few number of families, and it started to come immigrated families from Egypt and grow up step by step.
Issues as such in the beginning. In contrary, it was really very good, and people, they had such a great bond between them and the church, because they used to come from the airport. But the only thing right now was new to them was a big issue, which is the adding a new runway to the airport. By doing that, there was many aeroplanes in different times, and that issue caused a lot of noise, to the point that we used to stop the worship. If we have a service, we have to stop because no one is going to hear anything.
St. Mary's and St. Mina's Coptic Orthodox Church, first church in Sydney. Behind me is a playground, how we used to play handball. We used to play table tennis when we were younger. We used to have barbecues, fun memories. The reason why we left this church, as you can see, there's aeroplanes, traffic. So during the mass, there used to be a lot of noise. Plus, it's not safe for our future kids.
It was extremely bad. Planes would fly extremely low. We can see the plane as if it's like 100 meters away, and tiles would just fall off the roof. Yeah, very dangerous.
The government offered something equivalent to the church, and we had a house belonging to the church as well, youth house, and compensate us with the same value, and give us a compensation for that. And the difference, we did a loan from the bank, because we have here a very new church, and something extra, something according to the Coptic traditions, a brand new church.
Yeah. I remember once we had a retreat for the girls, and it was our first time ever to sleep in the church premises, and it was just different because I've never done that before, and I still remember the girls going crazy, especially at night when everything is so quiet and the lights are out, and they started thinking, you know, any noise or cracking they hear, they think, oh no, one of the saints is in the church, and they'd freak out, and yes, so that was funny.
I would like to say that the hand of God was with us and still with us and will be with us. And here in Bexley, we can see St. Mary and St. Mina, the intercessors of the church, and the name, the church named on their names, is doing miracles with us, and is a very wonderful church and very nice. And everything here in the church from Egypt, according to the Coptic traditions, many, many years ago, thousands of years. If you visit the church in Egypt, or the monastery, very old monastery in Egypt, you will see the same traditions in the way of building the church, especially the baptism, the site of the baptism and the icon status and the icons, all according to the very, very old traditions of the Coptic Church. This is great.
In the beginning, we have communicated this to the hierarchy of the church, the His Holiness Pope Shenouda, and we said because the church was so dear to the congregation here in Sydney, because it was the first church, and we have the idea to have it as a Coptic Pharaonic Museum. To show the Australian society the culture, the Pharaonic culture, and as well as like the Coptic culture, following the pharaohs. And it was a brilliant idea, and we have communicated this to Macquarie University. I remember Dr. Kanawati, who is the professor of the Egyptology there, he came to the church and we started to put a plan, and we discussed everything, and many youth were involved at that time. And until a certain point, you know, we applied to the council, and the council has given us this to have it as a Coptic Pharaonic Museum, and we were so excited as well. Nowadays, I heard that that project is not going to go ahead for different reasons. I'm not quite sure about it, but I think they decided to knock it down. And that's how.
To be honest with you, I have no idea. I heard we were going to get a museum or something there, and I remember seeing a video with Bishop Daniel signing some papers, but that's the last I heard about it. Personally, I'd like to see it turn into a youth centre. I mean, you got two stories there, and you've got, you know, quite a lot of space around it, which I think, you know, they can use, you know, as a youth centre for people to go play indoor soccer, table tennis. The building's got a lot of potential, and whether or not, you know, it's going to be used for a museum or for that, only the future will tell.